Corinna Hess. I am an assistant professor here at the Technical University of Munich, working in the area of bioinorganic chemistry. And under that broad umbrella of bioinorganic chemistry, what we are interested in is we are working on the development of molecular catalysts for many energy-related processes. So we are developing catalysts, for example, for hydrogen production, as well as systems for photochemical reactions. In developing these systems, we are taking our cue from nature. So many of our systems are bio-inspired, so we try to figure out how nature carries out these reactions and then implement some of these ideas into the design of our catalysts for similar chemistry. Most irritating is really this implication that you only have your job because you're a woman, or you only have the opportunities that you had because you're a woman. The other thing, which I thought is not exactly irritating, but was really surprising, is that I had this experience where I went to get my hair cut, and the woman who was cutting my hair asked me what I did. And so I said I was a woman in chemistry at the university here. She was completely shocked. She said, "What? A woman professor? And in chemistry." So this was something she couldn't even fathom. And I find this puzzling for many reasons, because throughout my education, and even now as I'm teaching all these students, there's so many fantastic, talented women at the undergraduate level, at the PhD level. And yet if you look around in the department, in most departments, there are very few women. So clearly we're not getting the message across to these women. I think what's more worrisome is that the fewer women there are in science, the fewer women there are in any workplace, the worse the situation becomes. For one part, you don't have many role models. Second, there is, of course, more of a burden on every woman to be part of committees, to share more role, the token role as a woman in science. But I think even more so, there have been a lot of studies that show that in an environment where there are a few women at the top and it's not a supportive environment, women start to turn against each other. They actually undercut each other and sabotage each other, because there's this perception that there's only so much room at the top and there's only so many resources to go around. And so what happens is often what they'll do is make sure they collaborate with the men, who maybe are seen to have all the power, but stay away from the women. And they want to avoid this perception that they might be biased. And so that, of course, is then a vicious circle. Yes, I mean, I think overall I've had fantastic colleagues. I've had fantastic people that I've worked for, a great environment of colleagues, but there have definitely been instances where I would say that I've been in situations where people have been very disrespectful, where I've been berated, people are very condescending, treat you as if you're their subordinate rather than your co-worker, and there are definitely situations where I've said, if it was a man in my place, it probably that encounter wouldn't have happened that way. I think you need a lot of luck. I mean, for one, it's a fantastic opportunity to engage with all of these different scientists. And that, of course, helps my career and my own research, because we have such a diverse group of people, particularly in terms of the type of research that they're doing. And so it really allows me to take my research in a completely new direction. And I think for the econversion with respect to women in science, I think they're trying to do all the right things. I think they're really trying to promote women in science. They're trying to bring more opportunities for early career researchers and women also to develop their careers. They have mentorship programs planned. They also have support for families, not just women, but anybody with families. That's part of the econversion mission.